Hey guys, how are you doing?
I'm well.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Okay. Dividends is pretty straightforward. I'm not going to cover it, but it's important to understand with dividends, sometimes they can disappear completely. And the interesting part, you don't have to own the company for whole year to own dividends. You can own them one day.
So if I buy 100,000 CBA stocks just one day before I get paid dividend, then
Not the same day. On the payday, you have to hold it practically 3 days because in reality, when you buy it, you don't become owner straight away. It takes a couple of days to become the owner. But yes, if you own the shares one specific day when they say, okay, whoever owns those shares on that particular day, you're going to get paid. Right, that's the way. Now, okay, options, who knows what options are? All right, great, fantastic. Now, we look at call option, it's called, all right, there are put and call options. Now we're going to look at call options, and we look at reasons why you can sell the option and why some people buy an option. Okay, you need to understand that, because some people, who's going to bloody get my shares, right? What's the point? Okay, so I'll explain you why. And where the best place to trade options, and what profit you can expect from options. Okay. Now, selling call option, is giving the right, but not the obligation, to buy from you the underlying product for a specific price until a certain date. It's a contract. I just tried to explain it really, really simple, okay, for you guys. Now, imagine that you're a shop owner, and you own the shop which sells bags, okay? And you have a bag which normally costs $1,300, and now it's on sale for $1,000. And then a lady walks in, and she, oh my goodness, I wanted to buy this bag, and it was $1,300, now it's $1,000, I'm going to buy it. But I don't have cash on me, and also I have to consult with my husband, right? So, can you hold it for me? And you're saying, wait a second, I can sell it maybe in 5 years' time. Why would I do it? She's saying, I'm going to give you $50 now, and you hold it. And then I come back and pay you $1,000. So this $15, what? It's a holding fee, right? So if she doesn't come back within $1,000 within next week, so you agree to keep that back for a week, you take it from the shelf and put it under the shelf. If she doesn't come back, she loses her $50. 50 is the price for the option, okay? The option to buy within a week. She paid 50 to hold the right to purchase the underlying product, the dream bag, at a fixed price, 1,000. You cannot change it, okay, at that moment, within a certain time frame, which is a week, okay? So she's guaranteed that bug will be there for just 1,000 and not be sold to anyone else. It's a contract for the whole week. But important to understand that she doesn't have to come back. It's not the obligation from her side, right? She has the option to drop the deal and give up her 50 bucks, okay? Now, from your side, you're profiting on that because you would sell it for 1,000, now you get 50 in anyway, regardless if she comes back or not, because you get this 50, right? And then you can, if she doesn't come back within a week, what you do? You take the bag and you sell it for 1,000. Okay, that's your problem. Okay, exactly the same. Now, key elements with options. Strike price. In this particular case, it was 1,000. So you agree on that price in the stock market as well, and I assure you. The premium, it's the option cost, which is 50%. The underlying product, the handbag. On the stock market, the shares, index, like whatever. Okay, the expiry date, the week. On the stock market, it could be, usually it's in America, third Friday of each month, but now it's weekly option. So each Friday, practically some companies, they have the expiration. So you can rent it for 1 week, okay? Then the type of option, the right to buy, okay, this specific. Now, let's have a look at example with shares. If you bought a share for $10, and then you sell the call option for 1 month with a strike price of $11 and receive the premium of 50 cents. Now, a buyer pays you 50 cents for the right to buy your shares at $11 at any time. It doesn't have to be last day. He can buy it at any time during next month. Buyer believes why that person is doing that. They believe that the share price will grow up, all right, during that period of time, and she will purchase it from you for $11 and then sell at whatever price is there. Okay, that's, and they reduce their risk, because if the share price goes to $5, they lose only 50. That's motivation behind that, okay? There could be two outcomes of this deal, and some people already know what can happen. Now we'll look at your calculations, and then we'll look at calculations for other person. And in this case, it would be clear for you why there is always more buyers than sellers, okay? Now we buy share 10, sell options with a strike price of 11, and we get 50 cents. By the way, you get this 50 cents straight away. So it's cash, what you can do straight away. Invest them again, okay, do something more. Now, two possible outcomes. First, the price will stay below $11. What will happen? That person, is he going to buy shares from you at $11 price? No, what's the point, right? So what happens with 50 cents? He loses them, you keep them.
Yeah.
Okay, what's your profit?
50 cents.
50 cents. Like you invest $10, what's the profitability?
5%.
Mm-hmm. Is it good? Or good? It's amazing, right? Now, the price grows above $11. What happens in this case? Is he going to buy shares of you?
Yes.
Definitely, right? Because he can sell it, or she can sell it at a higher price. Now, what's the profit here? 50 cents, plus what you got, all right, plus $1 is difference, which is $1.50. What's the percentage?
15%.
Is it good or even better, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, there is incorrect here. There is no reason. Of course, there is a reason. Now, let's have a look. Where is it? Okay, correct. Yeah. Yes.
Yeah.
Where?
The price dropping below 50 cents. Yeah.
Below
is the price tanks.
That's where every share price, what happened to it? Reduces to 9.5. So if it goes below 9.5, you start what? Losing money, okay? Now, and now you want to forget about this and come back to the first part of the presentation about value investing. Where do we buy companies? At a low. So we buy it when it's, of course share price can go down, but we're trying to buy it when it is already low. And if it goes down even a bit more, what do you do after that? What do you do next month when it's expired?
Sell
another call. Sell another call. You rent it again. You get another 50 cents.
Okay.
What do you do after that?
Sell another call.
What do you do after that?
Sell another call.
So you continue doing it. And I own some shares for more than 2 years. Because I always move this price, strike price, 11, then 11.50, then 12, then 13, and it moves up and down and on the shares. Because if I don't sell shares, I don't pay a lot of taxes, right? Okay, this is it. Now the next one, option buyer calculators. Very interesting thing. Total risk of 50 cents. And if you go to Option Edit, they will tell you, you eliminate your risk. You put your risk at a very, very small thing, 50 cents. And 50 cents control $10, okay? 50 and $10 not that much, but if you put 5,000, right, or 100,000, it's a very big difference, right? And two possible outcomes. The price will stay below $11. What happens with this 50 cents?
Just lost it.
Wrong. Now, if the price goes above 12, what happens? 212, for example.
Yeah.
You buy it then at $11, sell them at 12, how much you made? $1.
Yeah.
But then how much you already paid?
50 cents.
So what's the profit?
50 cents.
50 cents. Okay, so you invested 50 cents and you made 50 cents. What's the percentage?
100%.
So if you go online and you type make money on the stock market, you will see all these advertisements. 100%, 200%, 500% a month. They're talking about this leverage product. Now, if you meet Warren Buffett, he will tell you what? Which strategy to use?
My shares.
This one. He says stay away from that one. Because you can make 1 year 100% and then 1 month lose everything.
Excuse me, does Warren Buffett actually sell credit cards?
call? He can't, that's probably. Just because he owns so much money, there are not enough buyers of his options. But he does options as well. He buys shares with options.
Oh, okay.
So it's different. He deals it on a different level.
Okay.
Yeah. Again, for some companies he can do it, for some companies on a smaller scale. Because if you look, I'll show you later where you can get this.
Is it correct? I was thinking, so that no risk, there's kind of no risk on the selling the options, only risk on the share itself. Is that correct?
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because share option you get straight away.
Okay.
And here, let's have a look from probability. Who goes and play casino, like, you know, sometimes? All right. Okay, cool. Now, probability is a big thing, right? Even in black, red and what, black?
Yeah.
So
yeah,
two lines. It's like zero makes a difference.
Yeah.
Now, let's have a look. If you bought shares at $10, now if share stays at $10, are you making money or losing money?
If I've sold the option, then I make like 50 cents.
You make money, right? If you share price going up, like, you definitely make money.
Yeah.
Now, if it goes down to 950, you're making money or losing money?
You break even, right?
And only after that you start losing money.
Yeah.
Now, what about this guy? If the share price stays on the same level, is he making money or losing money?
Losing.
Now, definitely, if it goes down, he's losing money. If it goes to $11, is he making money or losing money?
Losing.
Losing.
If the share price goes up $11, you'll buy it
above 11.
He buys at 11 and sells at 11, and he already paid how much?
50.
So he's losing money. He's lost 50 cents. Now, if the share price goes to 11.50,
right, then breaks even.
Break even. So imagine the share price has to move so much in order he makes money, whereas you, it has to move down before you start losing money.
Mm-hmm.
So where is the probability race here?
With the option seller, with the stockholder and option seller. The guy on the left.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
That's the thing. A lot of companies, they teach this strategy, and I love it. Because more buyers, the more money I make.